हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम सचिन हरिदास रोहने, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, यशोदा टेक्निकल कैंपस, फैकल्टी ऑफ फार्मेसी, सातारा। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर फोकसिंग ऑन चिपेट गाइडलाइंस टू स्टडी फार्मास्यूटिकल इंजीनियरिंग, दैट इज यूनिट ऑपरेशन। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट द लेक्चर। हियर यूनिट ऑपरेशन गिव्स अ आइडिया अबाउट फर्स्ट दैट इज स्पेसिफिक फिजिकल ऑपरेशन, देन इट गिव्स एन आइडिया अबाउट डिफरेंट इक्विपमेंट एंड इट्स डिजाइन, then material of construction and operation, and also it gives an idea about calculation of various physical parameter like mass flow, heat flow, then mass balance, etc. So everything is just we are looking for or looking in the unit operation subject, right? So this unit operation subject contribute in 11 parameter, that is 1 fluid flow, 2 heat and mass transfer, 3rd filtration, 4th centrifugation, 5th size reduction, 6th mixing of solid, 7th extraction, 8th distillation, 9th evaporation, 10th crystallization, and 11th drying. Right. So we will check out one by one. Right. You know, aspect that how to study for CPET examination. Right. Which point should be covered under all this topic. Right. That we are going to guideline in this video. Now just check out. Now first, flow of fluid. Now what to cover in flow of fluid, right? Fluid dynamics, that we have to cover the concept regarding fluid dynamics. Then go for compressible versus incompressible flow, that is the comparison between two types of flow. Then Newtonian on versus non-Newtonian flow, we already studied in physical pharmaceutics, right? Then just check out the concept. Now measurement of rate of flow of fluids, that is orifice meter, venturi meter, and pitot tube, etc. Just check out on what principle it is based and in what condition they are used, right? So check out its application. Then pumps which flow the fluid. There are three types of pump: reciprocating pump, rotary pump, and peristaltic pump. There are different example in each category. So you have to check out all this pump. By checking its principle and then check out its application, where it is applicable. So in this way we have to study the flow of fluid. Next, that is heat and mass transfer. Now how to study this chapter? Just check out the mechanism. Here there are three type of mechanism involved in the heat and mass transfer, that is conduction, convection, and radiation, right? So you have to check out its mechanism. Next, third chapter, that is filtration. Now how to study this filtration? Factor affecting filtration, most important thing, right? Check out which factor just affecting the filtration. Then mechanism of filtration, sedimentation, different types of mechanism involved in filtration. Now check out the mechanism involved in filtration, because the filter media is depends upon that principle, right? So we have to check out its mechanism. Then industrial filters. Now which filters generally used in industry, that is gravity filters, vacuum filters, pressure filters, and centrifugal filters. So while studying this filter, no doubt you have to check out its principle, then its application, and the exactly where it has been used or it is used, right? So in this way we have to study the filtration. Now fourth chapter, that is centrifugation. Now what to study in centrifugation? Most important thing, theory of centrifugation. It's a concept, right? So you have to focus what exactly it means. Then classification, that is filtration centrifuge and sedimentation centrifuge, right? So this classification definitely plays an important role while centrifuge instrument, while studying the centrifuge instrument, right? So equipment that is also called as centrifuge, super centrifuge, horizontal centrifuge, perforated basket type centrifuge, and non-perforated basket type centrifuge. While studying this centrifuge, you have to check out its principle. No doubt it based upon the classification, right? Check out exactly what exactly it is based upon. No doubt, second thing, its application. Fifth chapter, that is size reduction. Most important thing, why we are going for size reduction? Because we want to convert into smaller particle, fine particle. Right, coarse particle into fine particle, that is called size reduction. How to study this size reduction? First, check out the factor affecting, that is like hardness, right, some moisture, right, some are just like gums, like, right, sticky one. These are the factors. So you have to check out the factors affecting size reduction. then go for its mechanism, right? Like cutting, which involve cutting, compression, which involve force, impact, attrition, and impact and attrition. So these are the mechanism involved in size reduction. So check out exactly what it does. It means, right? Now equipment. There are 5 mills I have mentioned here: cutter mill, roller mill, hammer mill, fluid energy mill, and ball mill. So it means that you have to check out its principle, then which substance undergo which type of size reduction, or which equipment used for which substance. This is again specialty you have to check out. No doubt, different material use different equipment for size reduction. You have to focus on that specially. And sixth chapter, that is mixing of solid. Again, it's an important chapter, just like a size reduction. First, you have to check out mechanism involved in solid, liquid, and semi-solid mixing. No doubt, it plays different mechanism. It have different mechanism for each type. Solid having different mechanism, liquid having different mechanism, and no doubt, semi-solid having also different mechanism of mixing. Just check out the mechanism. Then equipment, no doubt, 3 doses form solid, liquid, semi-solid. So definitely, mixer is also different. First, liquid mixer. Propeller mixer, turbine mixer, and pedal mixer. Check out its application and the principle. Solid mixer include ribbon, blender mixer, and tumbling mixer. Check out its principle and specific application. And semi-solid mixer like agitator mixer and shear mixer. No doubt there is again subtype including agitator mixer and shear mixer. I have only mentioned its proper type, principle type, right? So these are the equipment used in mixing of solid. You have to check out its principle and its special application, right? Extraction, right? Extraction of drug from just like a crude drug extraction. Simply, it involves mechanisms such as maceration, percolation, infusion, and evaporation. So all these mechanisms have a specialty in their extraction process, right? So just study out exactly what is the difference between each type. Right, that is the mechanism involved in the extraction process: maceration, percolation, infusion, and evaporation. Just check out the specialty of each extraction process. Right. Then most important thing, factor affecting choice of extraction process. I already told you, different extraction process involve different drug to be extracted. So extraction process should be according to the drug. Right. So which drug suitable for which type of extraction process you have to find out. That is the need, that is we have to study in this chapter. Distillation, right? So here we have to study mainly Rolls-Royce and Dalton law, right? And some distillation process, distillation equipment, right? For example, simple distillation, then flask distillation, fractional distillation, azeotropic distillation, extractive distillation, steam distillation, molecular distillation, and compression distillation. It means that every distillation process involves different types of principle and different application. So check out different principle and application of each distillation process. So after distillation, then we have to move for evaporation. Here we have to just check out factor affecting evaporation, and then evaporation equipment, also called as evaporator. Evaporating pan, vacuum pan, vertical tube evaporator, horizontal tube evaporator, etc. All this evaporator is based upon one principle that is called as natural circulation, right? So this is a principle involving all type of evaporator. You have to just check out its special application, nothing else. In this way, you have to study the evaporation. Now last, crystallization. This is again concept, just like a centrifugation, right? So what is nucleation? Most important thing, how nucleation is taking place. Most important thing again, method to achieve super saturation. You already know super saturation. So you have to focus the methods to achieve super saturation. Once super saturation is done, crystallization will take place. Right? So it means that method is important for super saturation that you have to study. Last, crystallization equipment, that is tank crystallizer, and second is Swenson-Walker crystallizer. So these are the equipment to produce the crystallization. The last one, an important one, drying, right? You have to just check out the concept like dry bulb, wet bulb, and dew point temperature. These are the concept. Then you have to also study the humidity, right? So these are the concept that you have to study under drying chapter. I again repeat the same thing, ड्राई बल्ब, वेट बल्ब एंड ड्यू पॉइंट टेम्परेचर, दीज आर द कंसेप्ट यार टू हाउ टू स्टडी थरोली. ड्रायर इक्विपमेंट, अगेन इट इज बेस्ड अपॉन टू टाइप्स, कन्वेक्शन एंड कंडक्शन. आई मेंशन सम एग्जांपल रिलेटेड विद कन्वेक्शन ड्रायर, दैट इज ट्रे ड्रायर, फ्लूडाइज ड्रायर, टनल ड्रायर एंड रोटरी ड्रायर. सो यू हैव टू जस्ट चेक आउट, आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड द प्रिंसिपल, बट यू हैव टू चेक आउट इट्स स्पेशल एप्लीकेशन वेयर दे आर यूज, इन वॉट कंडीशन दे आर यूज, राइट. यू हैव टू चेक आउट अबाउट इट्स स्पेशलिटी, राइट. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट हाउ टू स्टडी pharmaceutical engineering, that is unit operation, with respect to GPAT point of view or GPAT exam. So thank you for watching.